Hello, beautiful souls, and welcome to another episode of our Building Basics in The Sims 4. Today is the doors, windows, and stairs portion of our little tutorial thingy here. If you're new to this series, you can go ahead and press the link above, and that will bring you to the first episode. As always, a huge thank you to my community members over on Twitch for encouraging me to make this series, and I very much hope it's helpful. All right, let's get started. Okay, we are back at Midtown Meadows once again, and to be truthful, I did a couple things. Okay, so here's what happened. I already recorded this, but it did not work out right. So I went back and deleted most of what I've done. The few things I've left is lighting throughout the building so I can actually see what I'm doing, as well as removing the porch. The reason I did that is I had made a boo-boo. I had added a foundation under a platform, which was fine, but also created this issue with the platform and foundation trims. So I went ahead and deleted the whole thing. We're gonna quick lay that down again, and then we'll get into stairs, doors, and windows. Okay, so what I'm gonna do really quick is go ahead and hop over to our walls and empty rooms menu, and down here I'm gonna grab a flat square, just drop it down. I know I had it 4 out and then 5 down, and then I can go ahead and just match it there. And I guess we could technically like bring that in one so it's even. But I kind of like the idea of the side of the porch being a little bit larger. That's maybe where the grill is gonna go, things like that. Yeah. Okay, and now because I added that, it automatically matched the foundation height all the way around. And when I am working on stairs, windows, and doors, they all kind of go together. So here for the outside stairs, I want it to line up with the door. To get to the stair menu, we're gonna go ahead, go back to our little house, and then right next to the walls and empty rooms menu, we're just gonna click on these stairs. You have a lot of different options depending on what packs you have, things like that. But today, I am going to just probably use the unremarkable staircase. I want to show you something real quick here though. Some of these stairs have a under part building. I'm not sure what you want to call it, but they have an under. Some stairs do not. There is nothing under there. It is literally just the steps. But what if you really like these stairs and don't want the under? You can go ahead and just sledgehammer that. Boom. You're done. Unfortunately, you can't really add an under to those. It is what it is. Now, stairs, in my opinion, are one of the most temperamental things in The Sims, I swear. But we do have quite a few menu options within it to help us work with it. So with the stairs, we're going to use our less than and greater than keys on our keyboard. You also can go ahead and set it down and then turn it, but then you're moving it again anyways. So it's up to you. And you can see when the stairs are not against something that's already built, they're just a full height. When it is up against the porch, it shrinks down to match the height needed. In this menu, we have the same menu that we've had before of the move, the copy, rotate, and rotate. We also have these to widen, or of course you can shrink it back. As you can see, as I'm doing all of this, it costs money. So just be mindful if you're working with a budget that every little choice like that is going to add up. But if you're like, no, I really need a 3-tile across staircase, but I'm broke, you can save a little bit of money by grabbing your sledgehammer and removing that under. Now, I have unlimited funds because I'm just in the building. I'm not working with a sim right now, but if you just delete that, it will give you back some simoleons. And if you're placing a bush or something like that right there anyways, who cares? For now, I'm gonna leave it. So we have our staircase, and the reason I did it 3 tiles wide is because if you look at our house, we have the entranceway being 5 tiles wide, and I enjoy a statement. So I like it lining up like that. That's just my own personal design preference. Now, of course, we can also add railings depending on what style we're going for, anything like that. I'm gonna grab these, Boom. There we go. Now, one of the things with both the stairs as well as the railings is that you can't actually use the design tool to change the colors. So once you're set, you're set. If you want to change it, you're gonna have to go in and find it in the menu again and change it that way. Now, quick little side tip. Say we are all the way into building something, what have you. We're like, oh, we're going black and white for the exterior. We're going very modern. Well, you maybe don't want to go through all of the menus searching for this one again. You can always go ahead and copy it, and it'll pull you right to the item that you're looking for. I'm gonna put this back to green just for now, just because I'm digging it. Now, with interior stairs, this is one of the reasons that before I did the layout for the downstairs, but not the upstairs. Because when you place a staircase, let's go back here, I'm gonna grab the same but just in black. So when you place a staircase on one level, on the next level going up, it's going to need a landing point. So if we take this staircase and try to place this here, it won't work because when we go up, that is outside of the landing area. See, it's saying we can't intersect with the walls. So, what I want to do is I want to build a staircase right here. I want to make sure that there is an opening to this room here, as well as access to the bathroom, and I want to make again a statement piece. So, if we go back to the stair menu, now that we're dealing with a little bit higher of a height, we have a few more options. This little menu, this little button suddenly pops up. It allows us to bend the staircase. And actually, you can bend it a couple times if you want. Twist it, turn it, bop it. So probably not the staircase shape I am going to go for this build, but it gives you an idea of how many options you really can go. The other thing is, as you bend it, you get these buttons are going to determine how many stairs you get before each landing. So if we click it and drag it up, in this case, because we have so many bends, it's going to remove one of the bends, right? Now suddenly we're straight again. Let's go ahead and turn. Just have one bend so I can show you properly. So if we grab this and go up, the top part after the landing got shorter, the bottom part got longer. Can go back and we can go back again and have the reverse. So now the shorter part is before the landing and the longer part is after. Why you may want to do this? To build around walls, to create a little nook. You have a lot of different options. I went ahead and put it straight again. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and turn it and see here, if I want a door to this room, I only have one tile if I leave it like this. I, of course, could go like that, but then the entranceway statement that I had hoped for is kind of lost. I am gonna go like that. That way, I have a couple different things going on. I have the ability to make a little nook right there if I want it. I have a spot for a door. I have a statement, so when you walk in, you see stairs. It also helps divide this room a little bit more. The other thing I quick want to point out, if we grab a staircase, is I showed you before outside that you can do wider staircase, what have you, but you still can bend it. So if I made the bathroom a little bit longer, I would love to do that. That double staircase to me has such a presence and works so well in a large, grand home, but I don't want to extend the bathroom. I'm okay with this time it being just the one tile. Of course, we can grab it, pick it up, and sell it. There we go. Railings outside, not a big deal. You can pop them on and they're good. Inside, you start dealing with some wall issues that can happen. Go ahead, we're just going to take the very first railing today and pop it on. What is the first thing that you notice that happens? Get a little weird glitch here. That railing does not make sense. And unfortunately, in The Sims 4, there's not really anything you can do about that. Previous Sims games, you did have the option of having the railing on one side or the other. Here, no. If it's up against a wall, you're still dealing with the railing. So we can't do anything to really fix it from the first floor. But the second floor, we actually do have some options. And I briefly touched on this before when we talked about half walls, but I'll show you real quick. If we go over to our wall menu, go to the half walls selection, We have all these different heights, right? And let's switch there. We can go boom, boom, boom. You see where I'm going with this. I like to grab the standard half wall, and then what I do is just line that opening. Now, this does a couple things. One, it takes care of the railing from downstairs showing up. Perfect. Wonderful. It also acts as if you are a realistic player, you now don't have a tripping hazard or a spot for your Sims to fall down the stairs. It's helpful. It also gives you another element that you can play with design with. You can go ahead and go to the half wall trims. All of these are going to change the top of this. Okay, go ahead and grab a color. See more. So it just So you can see it just changes the look of that. Do it all the same. That's not bad. Maybe not that color, but we'll come back to it. Now, sometimes maybe you don't want the railings at all because you just can't abide by how horrible that looks. You can, of course, go back to your half walls and maybe not use it quite as a railing, but definitely give that little element of divide of security. Go like that, even if you wanted. I think that's the one. So that's the almost tall half wall. There we be. You also can change the under. It's just a wallpaper. You can slap something else on there and it'll work fine. I've said in the past, but I often forget, that I normally build with certain mods. These mods are quality of life mods for the most part. Most of what you can do through cheats. If you don't want to deal with debug or live edit or anything like that, which can feel overwhelming, I still recommend that you turn move objects on. So Control Shift C opens up the cheat menu. I'm then going to type bb.moveObjects on. Now the move object cheats is on. This will allow you to get a little bit better control of where you're placing doors, windows, all of those things. Control Shift C again to close the cheat menu. So you can go ahead and click on the little house menu again and click on the doors. Here you'll see we have short, medium, and tall doors to match the different wall heights. You can, of course, use smaller doors on taller walls. This is a medium height wall. That is a short door. This is a medium wall. Is there just a one? There is a tall door. This is a medium height wall. This is a medium door. This is a medium wall. I cannot even click on the tall doors. Doors are going to be pretty simple to place. You're going to pick a door.
Know exactly the door I want. Where is it?
I was absolutely in the wrong height. Okay. Ooh, did I see? Oh, that's mid. I went like that, but in a green. So we have our door selected. We see it. We know what we want. All I have to do is set it down. Boom. But if you care about which way the door is opening, things like that. So once you set the door down, boom, that's pretty much it. But if you do care about like which way the door is opening, whatever. So when you click on the door, if you click and hold, you will see arrows. This shows you which way the door is actually swinging. Open, shut, what have you. If you go ahead and keep pressing down on the left mouse button. Sorry, I've been trying to say that for a while. You can go ahead and turn it. This will change which way the door is opening. This is a exterior door, so I want to make sure that's opening outwards.
And that's it. That's how you place a door.
I quick move that door off to the side because I wanted to show you real quick that there are a few doors that are medium wall height that when you place them, they just kiss the top of short wall height. So if you want that floor to ceiling look, there's some ways to get around that. Once you have found a door that is roughly the same height as short height, most of the time you can go ahead and drop your walls to the short height and the door will stay. This works wonderfully. It just is barely above it. It'll be fine. We're playing. That gives you a much fuller look if you're trying to do the floor to ceiling look with your door. As you can see, this one, there's a huge gap above it. This one, no gap. That isn't the plan for today, so I'm going to go ahead and delete these, but I wanted to make sure to drop that tip in. Oh, even the medium door we already had chosen works. Fantastic, I love it. Now, windows are going to be right next to the doors in that same little house menu. And here we have the same thing, short, medium, and tall windows, wide variety of choices depending on what packs you're dealing with. The other thing I quick want to mention, you may have noticed the little curved walls menu down here. This is a newer feature. I haven't really played with it that much. If we do cover them later, it'll be at the end of the series when we've covered everything else basically and we're just picking up a few pieces. I do understand that they're still quite bugged right now, so that's why we're gonna wait. We're gonna give them time for the Sims team to get those fixed right. Now, with windows. Finding windows, I want to say, can be a challenge. Now, with windows, 9 times out of 10, you're going to have, if not an expansive set, a set of windows. If we take this set here from Seasons, for example, we have a small window, we have a 3-tile window, we have a 1-tile window that matches the 3-tile, we have an elongated window, we have a 3-tile elongated window, we have a super long window, and you also have another one that kind of matches but is also curved. So we have a pretty good set there. Unfortunately, you also will come across this, which is an amazing window in my opinion, but is pretty much the only one of its kind. There is no family to it, there is no matching.
Hi, Kitty.
Basically, when it comes to windows, you have so many design elements and challenges at play that I highly encourage you for windows to play with them, to go in depth and figure out what style and what look you are actually going for. The other thing with thinking about windows is that if you're working in a space, you want to make sure that the windows make sense. This is getting more into design elements, but I want to point out that if you're going to be working in a kitchen, think about the fact that you have counter height, you have fridges, you have stoves. All of these things are going to play into place of where you put your windows and what windows you use. All right, now we're going to do a quick little speed build as I go through place windows, place doors, and get us ready for the next episode. Real quick, popping in here to show you exactly why I wanted move objects on. Now, obviously with F5, I can go ahead and get it pretty close, but with move objects on, I can go ahead and press Alt and bring it right up together. This helps it look like it's one set window without getting the glitching of overlapping. Yeah. Okay, back to the speed build. Thank you. right, we're gonna end it there today. As you saw, I didn't do the windows upstairs because with the style of building we have going on, I want to make sure I can add the roof the way I want before I add the windows and have to go back and like redo those. Hopefully that was still helpful for you. Next time we're gonna work on roof and roofing, roofs, the roof, all that. Just a reminder, you can find me over on Twitch at twitch.tv/SourSuite, where we do lots of building and some other variety games. If there is anything you want me to cover in a future episode, please go ahead and comment it below. Either way, I hope you have an amazing day, and we'll see you next time. Bye! Your left muscle, holding your left mouse. Wow, come on!